Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue our music theory series right here at premium.busyworksbeats.com. Today I'm going to show you another Billboard number one secret Miley Cyrus is using to rank her songs high up in the Billboard charts. So again, I'm going to show you that hit songwriting formula put in application again with another hit song. Let's switch into the DAW. So this song is at 118 BPM. And the key is that, I mean, the key to the entire song is that it's at 3 minutes and 21 seconds. This is the same thing we saw in Taylor Swift's song called Anti-Hero. Okay, so 3 minutes and 21 seconds seems to be the golden ratio. Okay, so what I'm noticing in this format, because the song is highly built around the chorus, we find those two bar things that we found in the Taylor Swift song, which is these two bar transition segments. Now, again, this is something new I've never seen before in a lot of songwriting, is like a transition segment. Okay, so I think it's because of our formats are changing. They need a little bit of filler to separate the chorus elements from everything else. So we have these two bar transitions that we found again in the Taylor Swift Anti-Hero. We have 1, 2, and then another section at the end where it's two transitions back to back. I want to also note that in this songwriting structure, again, those transitions are separating the chorus elements from one another so that the average listener can understand the difference between a chorus and a pre-chorus, because they're like, this sounds similar, but it's different. That's what the transition's job is. Now, another key element about the songwriting style is that when the chorus hits, there's a dropout. So it has a sound, but it drops out in the very beginning beat of the chorus. So if we switch this to beat mode, that first beat of the chorus is like a dropout sound. So there's no backing sounds. It has like a little sample. I forget what the sample is. I can't play it on this video, but it has like a little sample, and then it goes into the big chorus. So again, this is almost like a micro transition technique for one beat, and that's when the chorus comes in. So let's go over how long these segments are. In the intro, I think they added an intro just to make the song long enough for the 3 minute and 21 second target. Then we're moving into an 8-bar verse. In this case, we have a different structure. So we have an 8-bar verse, a 4-bar pre-chorus, and then we have a 12-bar chorus. Okay, because this song really is trying to focus on that chorus. It's very soul-like, so it's very repetitive and gospel-y. The gospel part, I'm jumping ahead of myself. So again, 8-bar verse, 4-bar pre-chorus, then we have the chorus, which is 12 bars. And to separate the vibes, okay, we have this 2-bar transition, which separates the like styles of the music. And then we move into like a post-chorus choir type sound, which has like choir singers in it for another, 4 bars, okay? So let me switch this back to bar mode so we can count. So for another 4 bars, we have that post-chorus. Then we're moving back into, an 8-bar verse, 4-bar pre-chorus, 12-bar chorus, okay? And then that 2-bar transition that we keep finding. And this is something new. Again, I've never noticed the 2-bar transition used so much, ever. Okay, this is a new era, so maybe this is a new song segment we can add to our toolbox. And then we have here a post-chorus for 1, 2, 3, how many bars is this? 2, 4, 6, 8 bars of post-chorus this time, not 4 bars. Okay, this song really is like repetitive. Like it's the same thing repeated in different ways. It's almost like the whole song is the chorus. Then we have a breakdown section where we lower the energy of the track. So this is where we take out the instruments that are harmonically rich and we pull back a lot of those instruments. So that's 4 bars. And then we move into the 12-bar chorus at the end. This is our third chorus. Okay, at the end, 12-bar chorus into a unique 4-bar transition. Okay, so instead of using a pre-chorus, which would be 4 bars, we're using 2 transitions because we want to separate the sounds from the chorus into the post-chorus. And then we have the post-chorus that ends out the song with 8 bars, I believe, of post-chorus, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bars of 8 of post-chorus. And at the very end, it's like a transition into instrumental transition. So I'm not going to count that as like a post-chorus, more of an outro. So that's the format. I know that was a lot, so let me slow it down. In the beginning of the intro, we have an 8-bar verse. We have a 4-bar pre-chorus, a 12-bar chorus, 2-bar transition, 4-bar post-chorus, 8-bar verse, 4-bar pre-chorus, 12-bar chorus, moving into a 2-bar transition, which then moves into an 8-bar post-chorus, which then moves into our 4-bar beat breakdown, song breakdown, and then we move into our 12-bar chorus again, and then back into, instead of a pre-chorus, we have a 4-bar transition, and then we have lastly, I'll say 8 bars of the post-chorus, but technically it's 7 bars with a 1-bar outro at the end. That's the formula for Miley Cyrus's Flowers at 118 BPM. What I'm noticing, though, is that these songs all have the same length. So instead of focusing on which song element you want to put in, focus on the song duration. Try to get your song within 3 minutes and 21 seconds and try to arrange it to where you have 3 verses and 3 choruses fit inside of that 3 minute and 21 segment. So thank you guys. Just wanted to give you more info. I'm going to be researching more. Subscribe if you're new. Peace.